A fun piece to start our concert with by John Mackey, and I will bring that voice from out in the audience up on the stage to introduce this next piece for you. Some treasures are heavy with human tears. Please welcome John Mackey on stage.
Thank you. It's always, as a composer, it's very nice to get applause before I'm dead, so thanks, that's very nice. So that piece, very, very light. This next piece is not. This is called Some Treasures Are Heavy With Human Tears. In August of 2019, I'm originally from Columbus, Ohio, so I will preface it with that. In August of 2019, in Dayton, Ohio, which is about 45 minutes from Columbus, Somebody went into a crowded bar and shot and killed 9 people and injured 17 more in the space of 30 seconds. And I was contacted a few weeks later by a band director near Dayton, and she said that the first victim of that shooting had been in her band and had played trumpet in her band. And the shooter had also been in her band. And she had no idea how to cope with that. And so the only thing she could think to do that was a positive thing to come of it, possibly, would be to commission a piece. And she asked me to write this piece. And so this piece is not about a mass shooting. This piece is about grief. It's about what it feels like to know that something truly tragic has happened. It's been so wonderful to work with the group. And that's really it. I hope you enjoy Some Treasures Are Heavy with Human Tears. Thanks.
Thank you.
I'd like to introduce the next piece for you. You probably are wondering what just happened on stage. Why did everybody move? Yeah, maybe? No? You're okay with this? Bands usually do this? No, I don't think we do. We tried this in rehearsal just for rehearsal purposes, and then we thought, wow, that worked really well. There's a much better blend for this particular piece when we're all sitting random. So we thought, well, let's just do it for the concert. Why not, right? So that's what we've decided to do. And so I wanted to read a little bit about this piece as well by Alex Shapiro, which does have some electronic sounds in it as well. So Alex says, our hearts are equally shaken by moments excruciatingly painful and transcendently beautiful. In a world in which emotions are often blunted by the assault of overload, we cannot allow ourselves to ignore profound inner responses evoked in an instant. Awestruck, hopeful, grieving, longing, shocked, weeping, thinking, amazed, waiting, stunned, heartbroken, transported, hurting, dreaming, startled, dismayed, delighted, caring. What are the moments that have moved you? When my student Tyler brought this piece to me and I said, well, what are you gonna do on this concert? And she had been a fan of Alex Shapiro's music and said she really wanted to do a piece with electronics. And then we read the notes and I thought, well, this is pretty much perfect for this concert. So we hope you enjoy Moments by Alex Shapiro. And I'd like to bring one of our graduate conductors out. This is Miss Tyler Kapinos. And that was another fun one, wasn't it? Yeah. Thank you, John, for all the music that you create. It's just really, there's always so much fun and emotion in all the pieces. The next piece is, I guess we were kind of trying to figure out what else to put. We needed one more piece, maybe something short, maybe something to just clean your ears. That seems wrong now to say that, but a palette changer. Let's say that, all right? A palette changer. And so as some of you had heard in the pre-concert talk, and you'll hear from John again before Places, that there are some quotes of Debussy's music. So I thought, well, what Debussy piece could we do that's a little bit different than all the other music that we're performing? And I came up with The Girl with the Flaxen Hair. So this is The Girl with the Flaxen Hair, and we hope you enjoy it. And our next piece, we're actually just featuring two movements of this this new work, Concerto for Wind Ensemble by Kevin Day. There's three additional movements that I really would encourage you to also check out on YouTube. There's many wonderful recordings of these pieces and of these movements. I was really intrigued by the sound of these two movements. I enjoy hearing the more jazz elements and some of kind of the quirkiness of the first movement. So we think you'll really enjoy hearing Flow and then Riff from Kevin Day's Concerto for Wind Ensemble. Thank you.
Thank you.
Now we've come to the moment in the concert that I always hate, the last piece. I mean, I love this last piece. I absolutely adore it and can't wait to perform it. But for any of you who have ever performed a concert, you know what it's like. You also are having this great moment where all the work you've put into the pieces over the last week or couple weeks, whatever it might be, is now coming to an end. And there's so much music out there, so we have to say goodbye to these pieces as well, to say hello to new pieces. And in particular, actually, we also have to say goodbye to some of our students. And I just wanted to make note of some of the seniors. And seniors, I am doing this from memory right now, so you might have to help me out. I'm trying to remember who has had recitals. So we have Noah Brady on clarinet, who will be leaving us. Tyler Heinzen on trumpet. Well, you're kind of still around. Not really, okay. Jacob Parra. Yeah. I think I get to keep all the other percussionists, is that right? Who am I missing? Is that it? And Billy's leaving. Oh, no, Billy's not leaving, actually. I'm just kidding. Oh, and Nate, yes, and Nate Lee on trombone. Noah Palmer, yes, who played a recital on every clarinet. Seriously, it was a lot of clarinets. All the different clarinets. There he is with the largest one. Who else? Anybody else? And Aaron Ernst on oboe. And Stu on trombone. And that's it, right? I guess next time I'll write a list. So if we could give our seniors, our graduating seniors, a big round of applause, please. And so for our next piece, I would like to invite John Mackey again onto stage to give us a little brief notes about it. I really have, the last 3 days have been just incredible for me and for the students, and I can't thank you enough, John, for this. So thank you so much, and come up onto stage with me, please.
So this piece is called Places We Can No Longer Go, and you probably have figured this out already if you know what the piece is at all. It's a piece about my mother's battle with Alzheimer's disease. And that sounds like a terrible subject matter for a piece of music. I agree with you. That's a terrible idea for a piece of music. But a very trusted good friend of mine who's a conductor asked me to write this piece. And my way of finally figuring out how to approach it was to write the piece in, it's programmatic, it is really her story, but it tells the story backwards. So, because I thought nobody wants to hear a piece that spends 22 minutes becoming more and more confused, so it goes backwards. Which means the beginning of the piece will be very hazy, and you'll hear sounds that are very strange and disorienting, and then as the piece goes on, it will become more and more in focus. A few things that I think also will help you to understand what I was trying to do is that my mother was a soprano, and also she was an amateur but very serious flutist. And so early in the piece, the Debussy was on the piece or on the program earlier. What I do is I have the flutist on stage play excerpts of flute music that my mother used to play when I was a little kid. And I still remember her playing those things. And so you'll hear the soloist try to play the same Debussy pieces or other pieces. There's Ravel, there's Tchaikovsky, there are other things. But they'll all kind of just melt into each other. And they don't quite complete the statements because at the beginning of the piece, there's not enough memory to put that together. But my mother, at the end of her journey with Alzheimer's, she could no longer communicate verbally at all. But she could still hear music that she remembered and sing along with it. It was really astonishing. But because she couldn't communicate, the piece starts with the soprano in performing the piece, who will not have any text. So she will hear her making sounds, frustrated, trying to communicate with you, trying to tell you what she is thinking about, but she can't. And as the piece goes on, eventually she puts more sounds together that become words. And then the second half of the piece happens, and that's with the text. And hopefully you have a program which has the text in it. The text is poetry that my wife, Abby Jakes, wrote, and it's supposed to convey memories that my mother wishes she could still share with me. And the text is beautiful. Thank you, Abby, for that. So please read along with that if you can. And yeah, so the piece is very, very sad, but it is not bleak because it does go in reverse. So it will become more and more hopeful as it goes on. And it's just been an astonishing couple of days here. Like, this is true. Like, after the first rehearsal with this group, and it was so great, and with, you know, Dr. Bodnar, and I went back to my hotel, and I called my wife, and I'm like, I told her what was going on. She's like, that sounds like a gem of a place. And I said, yes, this is a gem of a place. This has been just wonderful to work with everybody. They've been so just kind and talented, which thank you for that too. So it's just been just astonishing. So it's hot here. It's a little too hot here for me. But other than that, I've had a great time. So thank you all for doing this and putting your heart in the piece. And thank you for programming it and bringing me in. And it's just been wonderful. So this will be Places We Can No Longer Go. Thanks.